మహాదిభ్యో బ్రహ్మ విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశ ఋషుభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన ఘన ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుఖే నమః. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదం టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ వెంకటేశ్వర బెస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, గుడ్ హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ టు యూ అండ్ యువర్ ఎంటైర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత సెకండ్ చాప్టర్ వర్డ్స్ నంబర్ 34. శ్రీ భగవాన్ ఉవాచ అకీర్తిం చాపి భూతాని కథయిష్యంతి తే వ్యయాం సంభావితస్య చాకీర్తిః మరణాదతిరిచ్యతే. కృష్ణ కంటిన్యూస్ యాజ్ అర్జున హ్యావింగ్ నేచర్ ఆఫ్ అ క్షత్రియ. This decision which he has made, it may go very wrong in his life. That's what we were discussing yesterday. Human beings we have divided into four category: Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra category, according to their karma and characteristic. We have to take the help of the words of Krishna. Then why by birth we have defined he is a Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra? No, we didn't do that. It's because of recent some confusion happened because of invaders, okay, because of invaders and because of lack of understanding. Why? Because if you understand thoroughly why people, means our forefathers, have made these norms in order to define your real nature. Because our karma will affect our life, not only that, my karma will affect me and the world. It's like a knife. The knife which is sharp in both sides. Therefore, karma is like a fire or the knife which is sharp in both sides. You have to be very careful. Because karma can make you, the same karma can destroy you. The same karma can help, will produce punya, to earn punya. But same karma will also take you to reach papa, pathala loka, naraka. The secret of karma, it's fantastically discussed in the fourth chapter. Karmanya karmaya pashyet akarmanicha karmaya sabuddhiman manushyesho sakrastna karma krut. So the secret of karma is very subtle to realize. Gahana karmano gatihi karmanya karmaya pashyet. So the secret of karma is very difficult to understand. Therefore Krishna himself says gahana karmano gatihi. A child cannot define its character because it has to have 15 years even to get complete health, to think about the world, to have a complete personality. That complete physical growth and complete this understanding state, it takes 15 years to reach. After 20 years alone, you know, a person is able to think something. Because, you know, in 12 years, he will get a good physique, but not proper psychological system. Because all these emotions and all, it comes from 12 to 20. After 21, he will be thinking like a human being. I'm not blaming, I'm not demoting, but the fact remains as the fact. Now, in order to define our own self, what the nature I own is very difficult. You need somebody to tell you. That somebody should travel like Krishna, who traveled with Arjuna from childhood. If you have somebody who can define, who can help you in every decision you make in your life, you are a gifted person. That can be your father, your spouse, your brother, or your friends, whoever, maybe. You are a gifted one. So now defining nature is very important, because you have to qualify enough to perform karma. Because karma, it has got its own ending. Because this karma is like a noodles. Okay? The beginning is known, the ending is unknown. Therefore, you have to match yourself with the karma. Matching karma with means what? Because when you select any field, your nature should support for that. If you are an introvert, your field has to be according to your characteristic. An extrovert cannot work alone. He needs people. He wants to share. He wants to share everything with all. He always enjoys people's company. If you leave him alone in a working place, he cannot sit as a clerk. He cannot just communicate with notes and books. He cannot even become an accountant. He needs to speak with the people because of the nature. So selecting field, it helps you to get inner growth and the outer growth too. Same way, introvert, you know, this introvert cannot be put among the public where he has to answer for all the people, he will become fed up. Introvert people, they find difficult to be in the public, means among the people. These extrovert people, they cannot be as lonely people. But Shastra says four divisions. Kshatriyas have their own nature. They don't worry whether life goes or not. They want to achieve. Therefore, Arjuna, you are a Kshatriya. Therefore, don't forget it. Don't commit this mistake which you are saying now. In our life also, if you know your nature and you can select the field, then life becomes heaven. If you select wrong field, I mean a field which is not suitable to your nature, you will make hell for you and you will become hell for others too. Your health will be collapsed, your ability to thinking, you know, that thinking pattern itself will get disturbed. Not only that, you cannot give, you cannot contribute anything to the world. Therefore what? Your field has to be, you know, like fish in the water. For that you have to be aware about your nature. So that for that alone, our forefathers have defined there are four characters. And elaborately in the fourth chapter, Krishna talks about Kshatriya means what kind of characteristic gunas are dominated. Sattvika means sattva guna person means, Brahmana means what kind of gunas to be predominated. So this, all these things we will see in the fourth chapter. But here we have to learn this field must be selected according to one's own nature. Any one decision, if it goes wrong, your total life will be in chaos. Therefore, Arjuna needs to be careful. Krishna is emphasizing more and more and more. Akirtin chapi bhutani kathayashyanti tevyayam bhutani. Akirtin, avyayam, akirtin, te kathayishyanti. This all entire universe, you know, all the people will say infamy that unending infamy on you. And that too, you know, it is worse than hell, death, for the people like who are honored, who are honored by everybody. You may die for that. Then next verse, Bayad Ranadu Paratam Mansyante Twam Maharathaha Yesham Chatvam Bahumataha Bhotva Yasyasi Laghavam. And your own people, you look your backside. The people, Maharathaha, great warriors. These all great people who have come here to help you. Do you know what do they think? If you retreat from the battle, they will think that, and you will fall from their esteem, because having been so highly esteemed by them, definitely will fall in their esteem. You cannot accept. That's what your nature is. And you know, even Parvati, Lord Shiva's wife, she herself made a wrong decision to see to go her father's yajna. Daksha was doing yajna, but he didn't invite Lord Shiva. Therefore, Lord Shiva, he didn't go there, but Parvati, who were insisting him to go there, and Lord Shiva said that, I'm not going to come. If you want to go, you can go. You know, this being a girl, she is always endowed with having love and affection with parents. When she goes there, she was not invited, she was not recognized, she was insulted even. Therefore, she became angry. She was not ready to go back to Lord Shiva. Therefore, she collapsed herself. So that we could have 51 Shakti Pithas. Even Parvati commit the mistake. Means what about Arjuna? If even you know Arjuna who commits mistake being near Krishna, what about us? Therefore we have to be careful. We have to be careful means what? We have to follow Shastra. Take help of Shastra. Shastra will define what the nature you have. Just you study Shastra, you will realize what the nature that we have, because it's very difficult to realize. So that our forefathers have defined, it's very difficult to realize. Therefore, what? We'll set a common norms, rules, not rules, norms, a kind of concept. If you are a Brahmin, Brahmin means who is, you know, completely endowed with Ishvara, Lord Ishvara, not having any wishes towards worldly, materialistic life. If he has the child, he will be also having Brahmana's nature alone. That's a kind of guessing job. You need not to criticize him. Somewhere it may go wrong. Because like, you know, we had a Ravana who was born as a Brahmana but became Rakshasa. But Rama, who was born as a Kshatriya, he remained Kshatriya, killed Ravana. Nobody filed the case against him till now. Because the dharma, when dharma needs to be protected, if you are born as a brahmana or not, by karma and guna, whether you continue as a brahmana. Therefore, you know, there is a verse also. That verse is, Janmana jayate shudraha samskaradvija uchyate Veda Pathena Viprasyat Brahma Janati Brahmanaha. When you are born, even as a Brahmana, you are considered as a Shudra. If you are undergoing Upanayana, you are considered as a twice born Dvijaha. When you study about all Karmakandas, Veda Purva Bhaga, you are called as Panditji. But when you realize what the Brahman is, when you are endowed with Ishvara, you are called Brahmana. That Brahmana means what? He is nothing but Ishvara alone. Kshatriya means what? He is nothing but Ishvara alone, because protector of Dharma. Vaishya means what? He is Lakshmi alone. Shudra means what? He is Brahmaji alone, who creates food and provides food. That's how our society has defined. No confusion. That society, you imagine that. So everybody could select field according to their nature. No psychological treatment are needed. That's what the big message we have to. Because we are, you know, in chaos, we are confused, we don't know where the problem began. Problem is because of wrong selection. That wrong selection is because of what? We are not using our free will properly. That's because of not having knowledge about our own nature. That goes wrong. Therefore, these last two sessions, you know, yesterday and today, if you want to become well versed, just you can see in YouTube, it will be uploaded. It is being uploaded regularly. You can see there. Yeah, be thorough and be clear in your life. That will be very much helpful. Next words. Avachya vadamscha bahun vadeshyanti tavahitah nindantastavasam arthyam tato dukhataram nukim. Your own people may lose esteem on you, but what about these enemies? These all enemies, you know, they don't leave you. They don't leave you. Tava ahitaha. Ahitaha means the people, bad doers for you. Then the bahun avachya vadamscha vadishyanti. Oh, they will say all unbecoming words to you. And you know, this, and also they will criticize your talent. Nindantaha, nindantaha tava samarthyam. Then what? Tato dukkataram nukhim. What else you need more than this? Means, what else distressing than this could be? This is Krishna's language, you know, to pinch him. Next words. Hato va prapsyasi svargam jitva va bhokshase mahim tasmad uttishthakam teya yuddhaya krita nishchayah. It's a very important verse. Hato va prapsyasi svargam. If you are destroyed, definitely you will gain heaven. No proof, but it's satyam. You know, when a person dies in the battle, even now, we give honor to him. We respect him like a god alone. You know, we call it Amar Jyoti. There is an Amar Jyoti in Delhi. Whenever I cross Delhi, I used to go there. Still, you know, whenever there is a time, if my time permits, I go and I stand, I go. Shraddhanjali, we can't. They are, you know, like, you know, protectors of our Sanatana Dharma. Hatova prapsyasi swargam, jitvava bhokshasi mahim. Victorious. If you become victorious, you can rule and enjoy this nation. Tasmad uttishtha kaunteya yuddhaya krita nishchayaha. Therefore, right. The determination for battle, to fight. Till now, this Krishna was doing normal suggestions, means he revealed about his nature. Now, once you started fighting, means if you are going to fight, now from this point, I will tell you how to fight. Means what? If you are going to work, I will tell you what kind of attitude you have to set with your karma. Now he begins like Buddha Yoga, means Karma Yoga. So Gita, whole Gita, this concept is fantastically, spectacularly given by Lord Krishna. Because this karma yoga is, we cannot find in Upanishads. Upanishad hits directly. It won't talk about, you know, these small minute things. They are on the top, it will hit the word itself, mithya. What exists is nothing but Ishvara, no duality at all. That's the message of Upanishad. But here, Krishna, being a friend of Arjuna, being friend of every jivatma, he says, sukha dukhe same kratva labha labhau jaya jayau tato yuddhaya yujyasva naivam papam avapsyasi. You have to fight, you have to perform your duty, but with a different level of understanding, with the different qualifications, with complete potential growth inside. That's what I said. A student, if he is endowed with Guru for 25 years, he will gain that capacity. Karma is like a fire, you should know how to use the fire. Karma is like a knife, you should know how to use it without being affected. See, these knives must be utilized for growth of you and universe. Fire also can be used for all people's welfare, but you should know how to be careful with the fire. In the same way, karma is the weapon, karma is a tool through which you can do wonders, but you have to be careful with that karma by which you should not be swallowed. Sukha dukhe same kritva. You should have the balanced mind. What is that balanced mind? You have to be neutral. What is that? You have to be in the middle. What? You should not lean against sukha. You should not lean against dukkha. You have to be in the middle. Will it be possible? Impossible. Because mind, it always takes a side. Buddhi comes in order to make the decision. A system itself, it won't help to be in the middle. Labhaha, alabhaha. You have to be in the middle between profit and loss. You have to be middle in between victory and defeat. Life is full of this victory and defeat, profit and loss and happiness and sorrow. This is a unique technique. And it's not a technique. It's a science. How to be it? Tataha yuddhaya yujyasva. Yujyasva. To mingle with or to be ready and commit to a science. Then you won't be affected by papa. It's a very big secret. He says, this Bhagavad Gita introduces now the secret of karma yoga. This karma yoga is a big weapon. This weapon will help you to come out of all kinds of problem. Then he himself continues, because Arjuna first time his eyes have become big. What is that? Will it be possible or not? Like us. But Krishna himself, he continues, Esha te bhihita sankhye buddhir yoge tvimam shrunu buddhya yukto yaya partha karma bandham prahasyasi. Yesha buddhihi te sankhye abhihita imam shrunu. Sankhye, so it was told as a Sankhya buddhi earlier, again you listen to me carefully. By endowing with this buddhi yoga, you can come out of all this karma bandha, bondage. Now two words are new. What is that? You can come out of bondage. And one more is Buddhi Yoga. This Buddhi Yoga alone as known as a Karma Yoga. Why it is called Karma Yoga? Because be careful. Because this teaching which I am endowed with, it's a gift which I got from my Guru Maharaj. After living 20 years in the spiritual life, then I had an opportunity to meet him. To consume that, you know, it only because you need to have lots of punya. And this portion is very, very, very scientific approach. That's what endowed with. Now, why it is called as Buddhi Yogaha? Yogaha means here, it's a science. The science completely which has to be observed, has to be followed, has to be utilized here. Buddhi. In intellectual level. Because karma is not outside. What, Swamiji? Yes, of course, karma is not outside. Karma exists inside. You know, karma is not outside. And note the points which I teach now. Karma is not outside. Because when I was crossing today morning, there was a flyover which is being constructed. On JCB was working, you know. That person, he was just lifting certain, I can call it clay. Sand clay, and he was putting on the newly constructed place, you know, on overbridge. Now JCB, when he was operating the JCB, he operated for 3 hours. Then after completing that 3 hours, he said, I have made 40 feet road. JCB doesn't say, that sand clay doesn't say, you know, but he says. His hands doesn't say, but he says, I made a road. What did he do? Only he was replacing this sand clay from one place to another place. That's what he did. But he has a conclusion, I have made a road. I have paved the road. Therefore, karma is not outside. Swamiji, is it a statement or is it a fact? That we have to continue. We have to continue. It's a big secret. Because everything is inside. Even karma is also inside. Okay, Swamiji, that karma is inside. What about karma phala? That we have already seen, but karma phala may be outside. Maybe outside means what? As the phala, fruit of others people. No, it's confusing. No, there is no confusion. We will see one by one. The secret of karma means Buddhi Yoga. This Buddhi Yoga is a huge gift by Lord Krishna. It's a magic. Same karma will become as an armor for you from the bondage. And this karma, you know, when you perform with ignorance, it gives a different fruit. When you perform with an attitude as a sadhaka, then it produces a different fruit called chitta shuddhi. Then after knowledge, you know, after achieving knowledge, when you perform, it will be called loka sangraham. It's a magic of karma. That's what Gita is. Gita is a supreme science, you know. So without Gita, don't study Upanishad. You cannot understand anything. Therefore, you know, traditional teachers, they don't accept. And side by side, you know, Gita, when you study Gita, you have to study some other books too. There are texts, you know. But you know, we got the fortunate an opportunity to share with each other. I thank Almighty for this opportunity, and I am also very happy to share this teaching which I got from my gurus. We will continue with Venkateswara's grace. Oh, thank you. We will see in the next episode tomorrow. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi. Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi. Om. Om Namo Venkateshaya.